going to quickly go through kind of some band monitoring that we've been doing over the last, since well before our ban went into effect. Actually, as I mentioned, we've been looking at PAHs in Austin. But once our ban went into effect, we really wanted to know whether our ban would reduce the kind of the PAH problem around Austin. It's only been 6 years, and as I think Barbara Mahler kind of stated pretty clearly, these are very stable and long-lived compounds. They're going to be out in the environment for a long time. And also, we believe, and we still see them out there. There's a lot of legacy sources in Austin still that are still shedding some quantity of sealant from those aging lots. So we're still getting influxes probably. So we think it's still too early to make any kind of strong conclusions about how well this ban is working on reducing pH loads to Austin's water sources. We also have noted recently, we looked at some of the character of the pHs that we're seeing in our water bodies, and a lot of them are those larger, more benzene-ringed, heavier pHs, and kind of generally suggesting that they're older in character. So we're thinking that falls into our assumption or our hypothesis that these are legacy sources. We're also seeing in some watersheds that those patterns are actually the trends over time are decreasing. There's three or four that we've seen that a very distinct decrease. But most of our watersheds are not showing any clear spatial pattern or temporal pattern, and no strong or even and in some cases there are actually some increases, and we're still looking into those. This graph that you're seeing here is our receiving water body, Lady Bird Lake, that kind of gets drainage from a lot of our urban creeks. And this is kind of where we want to look for long-term trends. We're really not seeing anything, as you can see, over the last 5 years since the ban was put into effect, pretty flat. Maybe at the end here, we're maybe starting to see a decrease, but who knows? It's going to be at least 10, if not 20 years before we're going to really be able to tell how much of an effect this ban has had on long-term PAH trends.